Hello students, today we are going to learn about 8th chapter of your science, that is motion, which is based on physics. Let us take its introduction. Basically, what is motion? In non-technical word, can we say that is nothing but movement, and movement is nothing but change in its position. So technically we can say that change in its position with respect to time, that we can define as in motion. Around us, number of examples are available. Birds are flying, fishes are swimming, vehicles are moving on the road, person is walking. So this is what all are moving from their one point to another point. They are changing its position. So that is what we can say motion. Now, this any object can appear as in motion for one person, but it may appear as in stationary. For example, number of passengers are seated in the bus. So all are, they appear to each other as in stationary. But one person standing at the bus stand, bus is moving. So for that fellow, bus is moving, bus is in motion. With that, all the passengers are moving, all are in motion. But within that bus, all are seated. So they appear to each other as in stationary. So this is what, as by whom that component or the object can perceive, can appear as in motion or as in stationary. Based on that, we can define its position. So how we can describe its motion? Based on its initial point. As we are saying, motion is nothing but change in its position with respect to time. So we need to define first its initial position, from where it start to move. So that initial point, it's known as a reference point, or it's also known as a origin. For example, we always describe our home with the nearby known location. So that nearby known location can be considered as a reference point. For example, is given, a school is in village, is 2 kilometers in north of a railway station. So railway station become a reference point, and we describe the position of school in the village. Now, motion along a straight line. A simplest type of motion is available, which we are going to describe, that is, object is moving in straight line. So the reference point or the origin we are defining as O. The final point we consider as an A. So object supposed to move from O to A, so it needs to pass through a point C and point B. So object is moving from O to C to B and reach at the B and reach at the A, at the final point. So total path is available for 60 kilometers. Now we want that object is moving from O to C. After reaching its final point, it means object supposed to move from O to C to B to A, which is my final point. And again it needs to come back at C. So how much path length is available? 0 to A, 60 km, and coming back from A to C with another 35 km. So total 95 km distance supposed to cover by the object. Now we want to describe a distance. Now that distance is a basically a numerical value, and that can be known as an magnitude. So the shortest distance from initial point to the final point, it is known as displacement. For the motion of the object from O to A, the distance is covered 60 km. So its magnitude of displacement is also defined as a 60 km. Now during the motion of O to A and coming back to B, so how much distance is covered? 0 to A, 60 km. From A to B, it is covering another 25 km. So total displacement is, so total distance is covered 60 plus 25, it's 85 kilometers. But while we focusing over the graph, between 0 to B, how much distance is available? Only 35 kilometers. So actual distance visible is 35 kilometers. But the path taken by the object is 0 to A and A to B. So total distance covered 85 kilometers, but directly visible magnitude of displacement is only 35 kilometers. So here we can say that magnitude of displacement and covered distance or the path length, these two quantities cannot be same. Based on this, we can say that the magnitude of displacement for a course of motion may be zero, but covered distance is not zero. If we consider an object to travel to back at origin as in final position, so what it needs to do? From initial point O, it needs to travel up to A, and it is coming back from A to O. So total how much distance is covered? 60 plus 60 is 120 km. But how much actual displacement is covered is 0. Starting point and final point is same. So visible displacement is 0. But here it takes the rounding path. So total distance is covered 120, but visible magnitude, visible displacement is 0. Now, let us go for types of motion, uniform motion and non-uniform motion. What is uniform motion? If equal distance is covered by an object in equal intervals of time, it is known as a uniform motion. For example, in first second, object covers 5 meter distance. In another next second, distance covered by that object, another 5 meter distance. In third second, object covered same another 5 meter distance. So in each second, object covers similar distance 5 meters. So this thing is known as uniform motion. But if this kind of scenario won't be available, means object is not covering same distance in the same equal intervals of time, that is known as a non-uniform motion. The motions where objects covers unequal distances in equal intervals of time, it is known as non-uniform motion. Now, how to measure rate of motion? To measure the rate of motion of an object is nothing but we are going to find out the distance traveled by the object per unit time. Rate we are going to calculate, rate of the motion, and rate is always related to the time. Motion is related to the distance covered. Basically, it changes its position. So how much distance covered by that object within how much time? That is known as speed. Speed is nothing but distance covered within that stipulated time. So its equation is distance per time. Distance has SI unit meter, time has its SI unit second. So speed is distance per time. So SI unit of speed is meter per second. We also can be defined as a centimeter per second or kilometer per hour based on how much distance is covered by the object. Accordingly, we can take this kind of units. To specify the speed of an object, we require only its magnitude. We are not focusing its direction. Now, the speed of the object may not be constant. As we referred in previous topic, if speed of the object is constant for equal interval of time, that is known as uniform motion. But if we consider a non-uniform motion, it means speed of an object is not constant within equal interval of time. So here we are going to consider non-uniform motion. For that, if we want to calculate its speed, we want to derive its average speed. So the average speed of an object is obtained by dividing total distance traveled by the object by the total time is taken. So average speed equal to total distance traveled by total time taken, v equals to s by t. V is average speed, s is the distance covered, t is the time taken to cover that distance. For example, a car travels a distance of 100 kilometers in 2 hours. Right? So average speed is 50 km per hour. But it is not necessary that within 1 hour 15 kilometers has to be covered. Maybe the different distance value is covered at different interval of time. But average speed is 15 kilometers per hour. Now based on that, we try to focus on example. An object travels 60 meters in 4 seconds. Then another 60 meter in 2 seconds. What is the average speed of the object? In 4 seconds 60 kilometers, in another 2 seconds 60 kilometers. So total distance covered 60 meter plus 60 meter 32 meters. And total time has taken 4 seconds plus 2 seconds is a 6 seconds. So average speed is total distance 32 meters divided by total time has taken 6 seconds. So answer would be 5.33 meter per second, which is its average speed of the object. Next, speed with direction. In earlier topic, we choose it only to derive a speed in which we have not focused on the direction. Now we try to focus to calculate a speed along with its direction. So while we combine a speed with the direction, we are giving emphasis to the direction to give more specific values, and that specified value of both speed and direction, that is known as velocity. I repeat, while with the speed, if we focus or specify its direction, so these two quantities we are combining, speed and the direction, this quantity is known as velocity of the object. So velocity is the speed of an object moving in a definite direction. It can be changed by changing the object's speed or the direction of motion or both. When an object is moving along a straight line at a variable speed, we can express the magnitude of its rate of motion in terms of average velocity. I repeat, when an object is moving along a straight line with a variable speed, so we can say that speed is not constant. If speed is not constant at equal interval of time, we need to take always its average value. So now we are going to take its velocity value because we are including a direction. So variable speed in the given direction, so we need to calculate its average velocity. So the velocity of the object is changing at a uniform rate, then average velocity is given by arithmetic mean of initial velocity and final velocity. So the average velocity is average value of initial velocity and final velocity. Initial velocity is defined as a u, final velocity is defined as a v. So average of two quantities, u plus v by 2. And velocity has a unit same as the speed, meter per second. Now let us focus on the example. The odometer of a car reads 2000 km at the start of a trip and 2400 km at the end of the trip. If the trip took 8 hours, calculate the average speed of the car in kilometer per hour and meter per second. Initial reading is 2000 km. End reading is 2400 km. So how much distance is covered? 2400 minus 2000, so 400 km. And how much time is taken to cover 400 km? That is 8 hours. So average speed is 400 km per 8 hour is 50 km per hour. Now we need to recalculate it in terms of meter per second. So the kilometer value we need to convert in meter and hour we need to convert in second. 1 kilometer is 1000 meters and 1 hour is 3600 seconds. So we are putting that value and recalculate it. So we are getting 13.9 meter per second. Let us focus on another example. Usha swims in a 90 meter long pool. She covers 180 meter in 1 minute by swimming from one end to the other and back along the same straight path. Find the average speed and average velocity of Usha. So now, how much distance is covered by Usha in 1 minute? That is 180, because from starting to the end and coming back. So 90 plus 90, total 180 meter distance is covered within 1 minute. So the displacement is 0 and its average speed is distance per time 180 meter divided by 1 minute. Now that we are going to calculate in second, so meter is as it is, but minute that we are going to convert in second, 1 minute equals to 60 seconds, so we are getting 3 meter per second. So now today we are going to end our session now. I hope you understood all the contents. Thank you.